In this world, there are so many religions, so many sects in that religions, and every religion, they are saying we have to do something to get happiness. We have to do something for concentration. We have to do something for worshipping God. We want to merge with God, or we want to follow the God. We want to reach to the God. But how, we don't know. There are so many paths in this world. And sometimes this is also one of the path to reach to the God, or say reach to the soul. There are so many paths in this world, but in that path we have to worship whatever God we are believing. We have to worship something, we have to chant mantra, we have to do some name of that God, we have to chant that name, or we have to do some meditation or some yoga, or some we have to leave something, we have to adopt something, we have bad things we have to leave, we have to adopt good things. And slowly, slowly, our goal is to reach absolute God. There are sometimes when spiritual scientist is there, there is a very easy way to separate element from dirty water. That physical scientist can do that two elements separate. Here is the spiritual scientist can separate pure soul and other element in this body by spiritual knowledge, spiritual science. And once we achieve that experience of who am I, what is pure soul, where is God, how to realize God, and by spiritual science we can reach to that stage, where is God and how to worship real God and how to merge with real God. So this is not any religion, but this is also spiritual science. And in that very fundamental things, we must know in this world, who am I and who is the doer behind all this happening. Because sometimes we are believing that God is creator of this world, God is doing so and so. But we have so many doubts, why tsunami, earthquake, world war, this terrorism, why this happening in this world? So many people has worries, stress, so many disease in body. Why this is happening in this world? We are believing that God is doer, but again question is arise, why God is doing so and so? We don't get any correct answer. That's why we are always having incomplete solution, and that gives us some suffocation or stress or sufferings. So we want to come out from all this suffering and suffocation. We must know what is reality in this world, how this happening in this world, what is eternal element, how to know, how to experience all this eternal element. And Dada Bhagwan, he is in search of that things. Who is the God? Where is God? What God is doing? How to experience that God? Who is governing this world? What is karma? How it is getting charged? How we can stop karma and get salvation? Everything he was thinking for childhood of this life, and he says, so many life, from so many life I am thinking for what is reality? Why in this world? What is correct things, what is real things, and how to achieve that real things. Lord Krishna, Lord Mahavir, Lord Ram, Lord Shiva, they achieved something beyond our intellect, beyond our ego, beyond our worldly people can reach that things. That's why we are praying as a them, as a God. So who is real God and what he has achieved thing? And Dada Bhagwan, he is also searching for that. What is universal truth? He got self-realization in 1958. What is universal truth? And he got this experience of pure soul as well as all eternal element of this world, how karma is getting charged, how to stop karma, how to get ultimate liberation, everything. He got realization in 1958.